Now class 9, chapter 10, the Mughal Empire. Today I will start a new chapter, that is the Mughal Empire. Now, we know that the Mughal Empire comprises a very important chapter of history, and it plays a very important role in Indian history. With the advent of the Mughals begin a new era of the Indian history. The Mughal Empire was established by Babur, who was born at Farganas. He was connected with Timur on his father's side and Genghis Khan on Mughal on his mother's side. Then the sources to reconstruct the age of the Mughals, 1526-1707. There are plenty of sources, both literary and archaeological, to reconstruct the age of the Mughals. Now, we know that in every chapter we come across the sources of history to reconstruct the age of that particular part of the chapter of the, age of the history. Now, here the literary sources, Abul Fazal's Ain-e-Akbari and Akbarnama. Abul Fazal was a great scholar as well as a leading historian of that age. Abul Fazal, he is best known for his historical works, Ain-e-Akbari and the Akbarnama. Written in elegant Persian, Ain-e-Akbari gives information about his army and the legal and revenue system of Akbar's administration. Page number 97, we learn from Abul Fazal that Akbar had a commanding personality. Ain-e-Akbari contains 5 sections or books. The first one deals with royal household. The second book is concerned with military and civil services. Abul Fazal writes of Admiralty Department, whose functions were to build boats and to recruit skilled seamen. The third book contains imperial administration, including the administration of law and justice. Akbar granted to his people the right to present position to the king for some legal position to be taken. This book tells us the purposes of administration. The empire was divided into shubhas, that is provinces. That provinces were subdivided into sarkars, that is districts. The fourth book provides information about Hindu theology. Hindu theology means religious beliefs. An emperor's fondness for books and persons with whom he could discuss religion and literature. The fifth book tells us about Abul Fazal's ancestors. It also presents an account of his life. Abul Fazal's another very important work, name is Akbarnama, is a primary source to have an idea about the royal court in the 16th century. Abul Fazal refers to the leading artists and painters of the Akbar's reign. Akbarnama contains a number of paintings illustrating events of those days. Number 2, other literary works. A few other historical works of the age of the Mughals are Nizamuddin Ahmed's Tabaat-e-Akbari and Emperor Jahangir's autobiography. Now, archaeological sources, monuments. The Mughal architecture reveals a distinctive style blending the Persian. The Mughal architecture is a blending of Persian with Indian norms of architecture. The most example are the Humayun Tomb, the Agra Fort, the Jama Masjid at Delhi, and Taj Mahal at Agra. These have many magnificent architectural features, such as the pronounced dome, the slender turrets, and the gates opening under the grand arches. Then the Red Fort. It was constructed by Shah Jahan during the period 1639 to 1648. It is a huge structure made of sandstone and marble. Within this fort, there are magnificent buildings such as Diwaniam and Diwani Khas. It has a circumference of 2.4 kilometers. According to Bernier, a ditch around the walls remained the Mughal times filled with water and stocked with fish. The Lahuri Gate, facing the end of the Chandni Chowk, is very imposing, mainly because of the excellent sight towards the magnificent central arch. The very important is the Jamma Masjid. The masjid was built by Shah Jahan during the period 1650 to 1656. Under the superintendence of Shadul Khan, the vizier, that is the chief minister, there are three gateways of the mosque approached by majestic flights of steps on the south, north and the eastern sides. The three gateways give access to an open court paved with large squares of red sandstone. On the west side of the court is the mosque proper, surmounted by three marble domes. The central dome is the largest and the highest. Now, Taj Mahal, the most outstanding monument built by Shah Jahan is the Taj Mahal. Now, Taj Mahal at Agra on the bank of the river Yamuna. This grand mausoleum was built in memory of his beloved wife, Queen Mumtaz Mahal. Taj Mahal is rightly regarded as one of the wonders of the world of his majesty and splendor. So these are the main archaeological. Before that, I discuss the literary source of history. Now tomorrow, next day, I will start to discuss from Babur, Battle of Panipat, then other important things of the history, okay. The Battle of Khanwa, okay. Then Aurangzeb at the end, but before that, Jahangir, Shah Jahan, okay. See you tomorrow, okay. Have a nice day.